So hello everyone, welcome back to another video explanation of very interesting problem from the recent contest which is set to max. We will be discussing both easy and hard version of the problem. So let's see what the question is asking. You are given two array A and B of length n. You have to convert array A to array B using following operations. In one operation you can choose a subarray and change all elements of that subarray to the maximum element present in that subarray. If you can make array A equal to array B using any number of operations, then print yes, otherwise print no. Let's see some sample test case. So we can take this third test case. So you are given array A as 3, 2, 1, 1, 1 and array B as 3, 3, 3, 2, 2. So in one operation, you can choose the subarray from index 2 to index 5 and change all elements in it to 2 because the maximum element present in it is 2. So array A will become 3, 2, 2, 2, 2. In the next operation, you can choose this subarray and change all elements in it to 3 because the maximum element present is 3. So the array will become 3, 3, 3, 2, 2, which is exactly what we want. So we will print yes. So let's see the intuition for solving the problem. So first see that whenever A of I is not equal to B of I, you need to do some operation to make A of I equal to B of I. So for making A of I equal to B of I, you need to pick some subarray in which the maximum element in that particular subarray should be B of I. If we pick this subarray, the maximum element is 3. So this A of I will become B of I, right? So we can do this for every index I. Let's see what will be the resultant array if we do for every index. So initially array A was 3, 2, 1, 1, 1. And array B was 3, 3, 3, 2, 2. So at index 1, it is already equal, so no need to do anything. Moving on to the next index, these are not equal, so we have to find an subarray in which the maximum element is 3. So we have this subarray. So for this index, we have to find another subarray. So this is the subarray in which the maximum element is 3. So this is also done. For this subarray, the max we can take this subarray. For this index, we can take this subarray because the maximum element is 2. For this index, we can take this subarray. So maximum element is 2, which is equal to B of I. So we can print yes. But is this condition enough to convert an array A to array B? It may be happen that choosing one subarray could affect the answer for other. Let's take an example to demonstrate this situation. If we have array A as 1, 1, 2 and array B as 2, 1, 2. Now we will iterate from index 1 to index 3 and whenever they are not equal, we have to find a subarray in which the maximum element is 2. So for this index, the maximum element is 2. So for this index, we are done. For the next index, it is already equal, so no need to do anything. For this index, it is already equal, so no need to do anything. But this is completely wrong. I will tell you why. The answer should be no, but our algorithm is printing yes. Because when we are choosing this array, the operation is affecting the answer for others. So after performing operation, the array A is becoming 2, 2 and 2. right? And we want so we will never be able to make this a of I equal to 1 because all the elements near it are greater than 1, so there will be no subarray which have maximum element equal to 1. And this condition we have to add along with the previous one, which is all the elements which we are choosing for the subarray, the elements in the B of I should be greater than equal to A of I, greater than equal to B of I. So this was less than B of I, so we can't choose this subarray, right? So we have two conditions. The first condition is that whenever we are choosing a subarray, the maximum element present in it should be equal to B of I. And another condition is that all the elements in that subarray in the array B should be greater than equal to A of B of I. So these two conditions are sufficient enough because we are ensuring that answer for one will not affect the answer for others. So talking about the time complexity, for every index we are finding the nearest element to its left and right, which are equal to A, B of I. This can be done in O of 1 by doing some pre-computations. But for finding out if all the elements in A in that subarray is less than equal to B of I, we will be taking another iteration which will cost overall time complexity to become order of n square. But in this question, the value of n is up to 1000, so this will pass the all the test cases. But for the harder version of the problem, n is up to 10^5, so we will need to handle each query in each index in order of 1 over order of log n. Now for checking out whether all the elements in that subarray A is less than equal to B of I, it is sufficient to check that the maximum element in that subarray is less than equal to B of I, which can be checked in order of log n using segment tree. Similarly, for checking if all elements in the subarray B is greater than equal to B of I, it is sufficient to check that whether the smallest element in that subarray is greater than equal to B of I or not. What I mean to say is that when we have taken this subarray 1, 1 and 2, the first thing we need to check is that maximum element is equal to B of I or not, right? So for this, what we can do, we can find the maximum element in this subarray using segment tree. And if this maximum element is less than B of I, then we can print no. Also, one another thing you need to check, the smallest element in this subarray should be greater than equal to B of I. If that is greater than equal to B of I, then all elements are greater than equal to B of I. So the overall time complexity using segment tree will become order of n log n. So this was the intuition for the problem. I will show you the code. So for the easy version, firstly I have taken the input, and for each index I am checking whether there is a index to its left which is equal to B of I, and if it is equal to B of I, are all the elements in array A less than equal to B of I, and all the elements in the array B is greater than equal to B of I or not. If that is satisfied, then it's okay. Otherwise, we have to check similarly for the subarray in the right. For the harder version of the problem, I have implemented the segment tree. First, I have implemented a segment tree which will give the minimum element in a subarray. And this is the code for constructing a segment tree which will give the maximum element in the subarray. And I have done some pre-computation to find the smallest index to its left, which is equal to b of I. So for this I have implemented a map which will be giving us the nearest left and right index where a of j equal to b of I. Now for each index I am finding if all the elements in that subarray is satisfying the two conditions or not, whether the maximum element in a of I is less than b of I and the minimum element is greater than or equal to b of I or not. If that's so, then we are done with that particular index. Otherwise we have to print no, because we can't change a of I to become b of I. So that was the solution of the problem. I hope you like it. Thank you so much.